was in 19:08:07 a.m. Good morning. Good morning. It's been a day or two, I believe. Father, thank you for this time together in your word. I lift up some situations to you, Lord. I'm not going to name them all here, but I do name some people like Bette Midler and Cher and Bette Midler, Cher, and Barbra Streisand, three of my favorite singers. Now, before I was in politics and before I knew that they were on the liberal left side, blah, 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 I still liked them, still love them, still do. But I pray for you to touch them and bless them. And, you know, I do as a Christian pray for their salvation. Of course, some people would just attack on that because they think, oh, how dare you try to get people to believe in Jesus and just, you know, just stop it, blah, blah, blah. So whatever. You know, I understand that because I was previously not a Christian. So I understand all that. Okay, I understand it. I understand the hate. Okay. But you don't understand. You don't understand something. And so until you do, then go ahead and have your views. I'll have mine. I pray for the entire salvation of the entire world, as a matter of fact, because I want them to all go to heaven. And some would say and choose, see, I'm just seeing such just outrage at everything. So, anyway. Okay, I'll get back over here to pray for their salvation. I pray for you to touch these people, touch these famous singers. They got a lot of followers, and they're very famous, and so they have a lot of influence. But, you know, they're just people just like you and me, Lord. And I'm not saying that you're just people like you and me, Lord, but you are. You came down to this earth to save us. You walked the dirty streets of earth, and you continue to walk. Thank you for Jesus Christ. June 5th, 2019, and our president is over. I believe it's called Portsmouth with the Queen and others celebrating the 75-day anniversary of D-Day. When people went to war to save, literally save, our countries and save us, future generations, from Hitler, from pure evil. And so, Lord, I have to think about these people that I think you're such a merciful God, Lord, that heaven is waiting for us. When we get there, that we will see these people that so bravely gave for freedom and for protection. And I know some people would say, well, you know, if they didn't accept Jesus Christ, well, we don't know if they did or didn't. And I'm just saying, you know, God is a merciful God. And so you see through it all, Lord. And I heard you say this morning, Lord, see the bigger picture. Always see things from the bigger picture. And so thank you, Father God Almighty, for the bigger picture, Lord, that we can calm down a little bit here and see things from the bigger picture, and that one day at a time, Lord, help us to trust you one day at a time in the name of Jesus. Okay, I'm going to sing. I should sing Psalm 21. The King shall joy in thy strength, O Lord. And in thy salvation, how greatly shall he rejoice. Thou hast given him his heart's desire, and hast not withholden the request of his lips. Selah. For thou preventest him with the blessings of goodness. Thou settest a crown of pure gold on his head. He asked life of thee, and thou gavest it him, even length of days forever and ever. His glory is great in thy salvation. Honor and majesty hast thou laid upon him, for thou hast made him most blessed forever. Thou hast made him exceeding glad with thy countenance, for the king trusteth in the Lord, and through thy mercy of the of thine anger. The Lord shall swallow them up in his wrath, and the fire shall devour them.
I just, you know, I said maybe I should sing, and I sang, and so, thou shalt make them as a fiery oven in the time of thine anger. The Lord shall swallow them up in his wrath, and the fire shall devour them. Thank you for your mercies, Lord, every day. Through Jesus, their fruit shalt thou destroy from the earth, and their seed from among the children of men. For they intended evil against thee. See, the devil is the one behind all of this hell. All of the hell on earth, the devil's behind all of it. And people allow themselves to listen to that hell, and then in their own flesh, which we just get such an attitude of, you know, and so that hand in hand goes hand in hand, and that's how awful, horrible crimes happen. That's how awful, horrible things happen, is that partnership with the enemy of us all. So you have to resist the temptation to be so outraged. You have to resist the temptation to let your flesh do something that will harm people, okay? And, you know, don't take your outrage out on people. Take it to the Lord in prayer, okay? Not to get somebody through your prayers, not to, you know, because, oh, believe me, you know, be careful with your prayers. We don't get people with our prayers. We ask God. If we have a problem with somebody and we're Christian and we know they need prayer and God, you know, touch them and convict them. Yes, convict them by His Holy Spirit. But we're not to pray destruction on people. Okay, that's not our job. Okay. Vengeance is mine, saith the Lord, I will repay. So the Lord in the New Testament talks about forgiving and blessing your enemies, because they'll need it. You know what I'm saying? Absolute people are going to need mercy, okay? And I've seen that firsthand when people have attacked me, where God taught me to, you know, pray for that person, their salvation, and pray for their protection, because the enemy is the one out there doing all the destroying, okay? And perception is not, it's not fact necessarily. What you perceive out there, the hate that you project onto our president, much of it's coming from just stupidity. I mean, you have no idea. You just don't even know what you're talking about. You know, I seen this weekend, and I'm not finished. I'm gonna finish this thing here, but I've seen attacks on Kenneth Copeland through a video that I forget who.
the outlet was. I forget. I'm sorry. I need to go back and look at that. But a journalist or a news person was asking him questions and basically just criticizing him for jets, having jets. And as a minister, he's just, oh, how dare you? Why do you have a jet? Is it against the law? Is it against the law for a person that's in ministry to have a jet? Not a whole lot, but I love him. Okay, he preaches the word. He's a word man, and he's a great minister of the Lord. And so, God have mercy on you all, really. And I don't say that with, like being a smart ass, but God have mercy on you. And then I saw the attacks on Franklin Graham this weekend. And the attacks on our president for stopping at the church. I've seen these attacks, and God have mercy on you. You'll need it. I'm not saying that to say God's gonna just get you. No, you're already out there in the enemy's territory. When you're walking in the enemy's territory outside, there is a chance, God forbid. This is why I pray for you. I pray for your safety. I pray for your eyes to open, because God doesn't want you to hurt and be in pain, okay? And when we are out there already, we're already open up to the enemy. So we run to God. I run to God and try the hardest. Not by the letter of the law, because that kills, and we can never fulfill the letter of the law. If we try to do it in one place, we have to do it in all, fulfilling the letter of the law of the Old Testament. Okay, even our own law we put on ourself, our own procrastination and perfectionism, if you know what I'm saying. I mean, this kills our dreams. It kills, and I don't use like to use the word that that word, but we just perfectionism, just oh, you'll never, never, ever get the house clean enough in order for you to sit down and write. You'll never get the house clean enough or get caught up on all the chores in order to do something great with your life. Okay, I know. I've been there, done that. I'm there right now. You do see me writing anything? Okay, I struggle with these things. I struggle with these things, and I the more and more I live, and thank God I'm still alive, because every day I feel like I'm dying. Okay, but you know what? The Lord allows me to go through these things so that I can have some compassion on people, because let me just finish this. For they intended evil against thee. They imagined a mischievous device which they are not able to perform. Therefore thou shalt make them turn their back. Therefore shalt thou make them turn their back when thou shalt make ready thine arrow upon the strings against the face of them. God will protect people. Okay? God will protect our president from your attacks. Okay, be thou exalted, Lord, in thine own strength, so will praise thy power. Bless A.G. Barr and his investigations. But what I was going to say is, okay, just an example. I talked about Bette Midler, Barbra Streisand, and Cher. They're all famous people. Famous women who I love their singing, and they've gotten over into politics, which is totally fine. It's their total freedom to do that. But these are people that we out here that voted for President Trump. Not everybody loved them, but I did. And now, people like me that loved these people made them famous. Spit on us, and that's their freedom.
But that's what they're doing. They hate us. And so I forgive you, Cher and Barbra Streisand and Bette Midler. I love you. I love you. You are great singers. I love your acting. I love your movies. You don't get it. You don't get it. And so I forgive you, and I pray for your salvation. I pray for your deliverance. And if you never come to Jesus, that's fine. That's your right too. But I will continue to pray for your salvation. And not only that, just that your eyes would be opened and stop your hate. But if you want to hate, that's okay too. That's, you know, that's your right to hate, okay? See, I love to be able to bring both sides to the table. And, but it's sad because it's like, I can never, I don't know if I could ever trust you again. It's like you're all washed out or something. I don't know. You know what I mean? Will you ever make another great movie or sing a great song and really be accepted by the total world? You know? I remember all your songs. I don't remember them, but I could play them today and sing along with them. Bette Midler, you sang one song, and I kind of dedicated that. I did dedicate that to my mother, you know. But you I need to come over here to, for us who believe in Jesus. I need to pray over us in our day, okay? Because sometimes things can get so wild that Matthew. Let's just go over Matthew 6, 4, our daily, because, you know, it can get really kind of scary out there. And I do pray for the homeless. I pray for, there's Christians out there that are homeless. I've been homeless 5 times. I thank God I had a car. One night I was homeless with my child in downtown San Diego, and then we struggled, but at least we were only homeless one night. It was really awful. And then I've been homeless in between assignments as a caregiver for over 10 years, a caregiver for the elderly. I thank God I had bought a car and had a car, because when you're a live-in caregiver, you don't have a house to live in, your own house. Many times for my 2 days off, etc. So, and you project him out. I hope that's okay with you all. Darkness.
No man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve God and mammon. Therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat or what you shall drink. Okay, this is for our daily. Doesn't God supply our needs every single day? And so therefore I say unto you, Jesus says, Matthew 6:25, therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, for what you shall eat or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body, what you shall put on. Is the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? Stop worrying about what you're going to eat and what you're going to put on. Life is more than food and raiment, yet he does supply us with those things too. Behold the fowls of the air. Look at the fowls of the air, man. For they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns. You never see them struggling. OMG. I love birds. Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are ye not much better than they? Which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit unto his stature? And why take ye thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They toil not, neither do they spin. And look how beautiful the lilies of the field, the flowers are. Look at how beautiful they are. And yet I say unto you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed. Wherefore, if God so clothe the grass of the field, which today is, and tomorrow is cast into the oven, I mean, here today, gone tomorrow, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat? Or what shall we drink? Or wherewithal shall we be clothed? Or where shall we live? You know, these things, these basic things of life, all this worry and all this fear, okay? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. That's what the unbelievers, that's how the unbelievers live. That's how the unbelievers worry. All the time, they're always striving how to pay the bills, you know, and it wasn't meant to be that way for the believer in Christ, okay? Yet it is. Yet my whole entire Christian life, I have lived like this because I didn't get it, okay? And so when you look at your life every single day, yeah, okay, maybe you only had a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Maybe you only had a peanut... But did he feed you? Yes, okay? So stop worrying, because you're not going to die because you didn't have the particular kind of food that you wanted one day over the other. God will let us go through these times where he will prove our trust. He will prove our trust in him and our faith in him. Read the Old Testament, okay? And the children of Israel, when he delivered them out of the hand of the Pharaoh, he over and over and over and over supplied their needs, gave them miracles, yet over and over and over and over they failed to trust him. Their unbelief was always about their unbelief. So I confess, Lord, I confess for me, I confess for the body of Christ, our unbelief. Forgive us, Lord. We have sinned against you for our unbelief. And that is exactly what people will go to hell because they had unbelief in Jesus. Now, I'm not going to get over into that. You go ahead and send fiery darts about that subject. Go ahead. It's okay. Thank you, God. You have freedom of speech. For all, after all these things, do the Gentiles seek for your heavenly Father. Your heavenly Father knoweth that you have need of all these things. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, his way of doing things, okay? And all these things shall be added unto you. They'll be added unto you. Your inheritance in Christ Jesus, It's by faith, just as Abraham believed God, and he was justified by faith. Okay? Therefore, take no thought for the morrow shall take thought for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. So let's not worry about tomorrow, okay? Today is where it's at. Yesterday's gone, tomorrow's not here. So thank you so much, Lord, for this day. Bless us and make us a blessing. Protect our precious loved ones, friends, neighbors, towns and cities, countries, Lord. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Protect, provide for, Lord. Heal and keep healthy, Lord. In the name of the powerful name of Jesus Christ, amen. You can find me over at Twitter, at Wanda Faye, and over at newsandprayer.com. Have a really good day, and God bless you. Bye-bye.